Hello friends, in this video I will show you how to get metadata from any PIGT file using the URI of the file. So here I will get the following metadata: the display name of the file, MIME type of the file, size of the file and last modified of the file using their URIs. So here I have created this project in which in activity main.xml I have a button 1, this is for picking the file. Then I have text view 1 for displaying the display name or file name, and then I have text view 2 for displaying the MIME type, and there is text view 3 for displaying the size of the file, and text view 4 is for displaying the last modified time. Now in main activity.java, at the top I have declared 4 text views, text view 1, 2, 3 and 4. And I have defined an int variable pick file equal to 99. In onCreate, I have set content view to main. And then I have defined a button 1, using its ID, button 1. And then I have defined text view 1, 2, 3, and 4 using their IDs, text view 1, text view 2, text view 3, and text view 4. After this, I have onClick listener for button 1. When button 1 is clicked, I use intent to pick a file. And here I have defined the intent as new intent.action open document, and I have added this category openable, and I have set type to */*. This means it can pick any type of file. And then I start activity for result intent, pick file. Here pick file is the request code for this intent. So outside onCreate I have this onActivityResult method, in which I check if request code is equal to pick file and result code is equal to result OK. And if this condition is met, then if data is not equal to null, data is actually this intent. So if this data is not equal to null, then I get the URI of the file. URI is equal to data.getData. And then from this URI, I get the metadata using this method, display media file metadata URI. So this is a different method which I have defined here. This is outside onCreate and outside onActivityResult. And I have defined it here as display media file metadata URI. So inside this method, I have this try and finally block. Try and in the end, there is only this try block. So in this try block, I define cursor equal to this dot get content resolver dot query URI, comma null. Okay, I have used 5 times null here, and they are for the projection selection args, sort order and cancellation signal. So from the using the URI, I get the content resolver, and then I define the cursor. And then inside this try block, I will be using this cursor. So first I check if cursor is not null and cursor.move to first. So if cursor is not null, then I move to the first item. So this works for if URI has more than one URI, then it will go to the first URI. So first I get the display name. For that I use cursor.get column index openable columns.display name. So this will give me the column index for display name, and then I convert it to string. I get the string form of the display name by writing cursor.get string. So the code is like this, and it will give me the display name, which I can display in any text view. So here in text view 1 I display the display name. Then I use a similar code, cursor.get string, cursor.get column index, mime_type. So this will give me the mime type in string form, which I display in text view 2. Next is the file size. For getting the file size, I use cursor.get column index ओपनेबल कॉलम्स डॉट साइज, दिस विल गिव मी द कॉलम इंडेक्स ऑफ फाइल साइज इन INT फॉर्म. सो आई डिफाइन दिस INT एज साइज इंडेक्स. Then I define another int called byte size and I set it to -1 initially, and then I check if this size index is not null. Okay, if this size index is not null, then I define this byte size equal to cursor dot get int size index. So this will give me the size in int form. Here I can use get string also, then it will give me the size in string form, but that will be in bytes. So here I am getting it in int form. Okay, and after this, if the byte size is more than -1, okay, if it is 0 or more, then I get the file size from the byte size. Okay, for which I have a different method. Here at the end I have this method, public string get file size from the bytes. Okay, so this is a string method, and in the end it returns a string. So it actually converts the bytes to either byte or kilobyte or megabyte or GB, plus it returns the unit, which can be any of these depending on the file size. Okay, so here I get the file size and display it in TextView 3. Next is the last modified date. So for this I use cursor.getColumnIndex last underscore modified. This will give me the last modified index in int form. And then I define a long variable last underscore mod equal to -1. Then I check if last modified index is not null. If it is not null, then I get cursor.getLong last modified index. This will give me the last modified time in milliseconds. So last mod will be the last modified time in milliseconds. And if last mod is more than -1, then I define a simple date format equal to new simple date format ddmmmyyyy, local.us. And then I convert this last modified time into a date format and display that date in simple date format and set it as text of TextView 4. And that's all. Here this if block ends, then the try block ends. Okay, the other if block ends, and then the try block ends, and then this method ends. So this method I use in on activity result, display media file metadata. Now let's have a look at the project. So here is the project. When I pick any file, yeah, this is streptococci. So when I pick, this is a PDF file. When I pick this, it displays streptococci.pdf, the file name. Then the MIME type application/PDF, and the size of the file, and then the date it was last modified. So I downloaded it today, so it is displaying today's date. And suppose if I pick this image, it displays it was downloaded on 13 October, size 40.77 KB, and MIME type image/JPEG. Okay, so that's all in this video. Thank you very much for watching this.